Well, as I've talked about repeatedly so far since the preseason started, one of the key elements when I handicap the games, and one of the things you have to always consider as well in the first 2 weeks of the preseason, is the quarterback rotations. And what I generally look for is when you have competition for the second or third team quarterback position. I use that to my advantage when I give you a free play with the Eagles against the Colts last Sunday. You may recall I told you that I liked the fact that Tim Tebow and Matt Barkley, the guys that were competing for the third spot on the Eagles roster, were going to see the bulk of the action after then starter Mark Sanchez lost. I also thought that was a key thing last night when I released yet another 10 dime play in preseason play on the Washington Redskins, because there, after RG3, who I figured would be ineffective again against a very stout Detroit defense, after he left the game, it was going to be in the hands of Colt McCoy or Kirk Cousins, and I felt confident with both of them. Well, it certainly paid off for me as I cashed in with the Redskins as they rallied thanks to Cousins throwing a touchdown pass midway through the fourth quarter. McCoy, rather ineffective last night. RG3, totally ineffective, knocked out of the game, as you probably have heard by now, as Detroit. Detroit's front seven just repeatedly bashed their way through over an overmatched and injury-riddled Washington offensive line. So I got the win, and I got the cover, and improved to a perfect 2-0 with my preseason pick so far. But then you look at the Cleveland-Buffalo game. And as I was talking about it in yesterday's video report, I told you there's that little voice in the standing there, that little guy on my shoulder whispering to me, it just looks too easy. I mean, Cleveland -3, you know, the Bills were without their top five running backs, minus their top three wide receivers. It just seemed too easy. Well, you come to see then after the fact that the Bills actually sat 16 players and the Browns sat 20. And yet the Browns were in position to win it. But then the third string quarterback again, E.J. Manuel, who really hasn't been given much of a shot by the scribes, writers, and even I think somewhat by the Buffalo Bills organization to claim the starting job. It seems like Tyrod Taylor and Matt Cassel are the two guys that are being pushed for the number one spot. And yet he played effectively in the Bills opening week preseason game, and his touchdown pass with about a minute and a half to go last night at Cleveland and the subsequent two-point conversion gave the Bills the 11-10 road win, catching 3 points against the Cleveland Browns. And, of course, that cost Brian Rosica, preseason winner number 5 out of 6 last night. So, again, it all comes down to the player rotations. Now, I'm going to talk about the Atlanta-New York Jets game here in just a moment. I'm going to give you a free play on the Seattle-Kansas City game. Plus, in baseball, take a look at your game in Anaheim between the suddenly struggling Blue Jays and the LA Angels. Last night, I took a split with the complimentary plays. Losing with the Nationals on the run line and winning with the Cubs on the run line, 52-27 run with those comp selections over the past 40 days. And last night, thanks to the winner on the Washington Redskins, I have now also won 24 of the past 39 days with my premium plays. But listen, today, before I go any further and get to the free selections, let me quickly tell you a couple things. Brad Wilton did it again last night. On the heels of Wednesday's Charity Play of the Week winner, a 50-dime total winner with the Nationals and the Rockies under by 4.5 runs. Last night, he bumped it up. 100-dime winner number 6 out of 8. And he delivered again with the Cubs on the run line. 7-1 win easily over Atlanta. Well, today, he's pushing it to the max. Biggest play again in his career in baseball. 5th ever 200-dime baseball release. He is a perfect 4-0 with these plays. They have all come over the past 3 weeks. You've gotten every single one of them at half price, and you will get today's at half price as well by using coupon code 200-dimer, 200-DIMER. Listen, over the past 4 weeks, he has had 14 plays, 100 dimes or higher. He's won 12 of them. You've gotten every single one of them at least half price off as I continue to show you that you do not have to spend big money to make big money. And today, again, half price play of the day. Keep in mind, he's going for winning day number 31 out of 47. And over the past 46 days, $10 bettors have won a cool $17,600 and some dollars. 5th ever 200 dime play, half price play of the day. 200 dimer, 200-DIMER is your coupon code. Also, the winningest football handicapper here at the site, over the past 5 years, hands down, Shawn Michaels, making $10 bettors in pro and college football, a little over 30 grand in that span. Last week, first two NFL preseason plays, he delivered with the Texans over San Francisco, 25 dime release on Saturday, winner easy. Delivered on Sunday, 25 dime play, Eagles, another double-digit winner, easy, over the Colts. You got both of those plays at a savings of $75 off the regular price. Same thing goes today for Shawn Michaels. Boy, talk about mincing words and mixing guys up. Shawn Michaels saved $75 again. Tonight, his best bet, Seahawks and Chiefs. You get it for $24 simply by using coupon code WEEK2, W-E-E-K, and the number 2, no space between them. All your other promos, etc., are over on the homepage. You know the charity play of the week. I told you that, once again, I returned to that little 4-year-old boy who at the age of 18 months had cancer surgery, and his family was struggling to pay the bills associated with various types of physical therapy, hypotherapy, water therapy, etc., because the type of cancer he had also left his muscles in extreme pain. I thought that it would be a great thing to go ahead and use them once more, because so many times I pick a charity recipient and they get close to their goal, but they just don't quite get there. And I like to come back a second, sometimes a third, hell, sometimes 5 or 6 times until they eventually reach their goal. Well, you guys responded in kind yesterday. You'll see my donation on the page as well. But I just want to pass something on to you that you may not have read from this little 4-year-old boy. His name is Mac. His mother posted today that he's having a really hard time with physical therapy and hypotherapy. Usually only makes it about 10 to 20 minutes in physical therapy and about 30 minutes in hypotherapy because of the intense pain he's in, that they're seeing some new pain management doctors and may have to go to University of Cincinnati Hospital, which is like a 5.5-hour drive for them each way. But of course, like anybody else out there, you and me included, they'll do anything to help their child in this time of need. However, they also put, and this is something I wanted to pass on to you, thank you, Al DeMarco, for helping us raise funds. Every single cent helps right now. Please lift Mac and our family up in prayer as we push forward to try and help our sweet 4-year-old. And guys, again, without you, there is no Charity Play of the Week program. Okay, let's get to your complimentary play here. First one, well, I'll take a look at the football game first. I don't mind going football, and then we'll come back to baseball, even though the baseball game, of course, is a West Coast start. But let's talk about Kansas City and Seattle here. This is a game where Kansas City tonight is playing at home, and they are a 3-point favorite against the Seahawks. Now, listen, the Seahawks did absolutely nothing well in last week's home loss to the Denver Broncos. They lost that game 22-20 in that game. The offensive line, just in total disarray. Russell Wilson had no time in the pocket. In fact, Tavarius Jackson, his backup, also sacked in that game because he was constantly under pressure, suffered a high ankle sprain that's going to keep him out at least 2 weeks, so he will not be playing tonight. So after Russell Wilson gives way, it's going to be R.J. Archer, I think is his name. Yeah, R.J. Archer. He's going to see the bulk of the duty in this game for the Seahawks here in this road game. How bad was it for Seattle last week? Well, Seattle in that loss to Denver lost 2 fumbles, and their quarterbacks were sacked 7 times. Now, true, the first-team offense only played 10 snaps. The first-team defense only played 13 snaps. I cannot talk today. This is what happens when you work all night and you handicap games and you get absolutely no sleep. Snaps is what I meant to say for the defense, 13 snaps. Seattle offense didn't even score a touchdown until 3 minutes were left in the game. Only had 181 net yards of offense in the game. Defensively, you know, the Legion of Boom. They're not there. Cam Chancellor is holding out. Earl Thomas just returned to practice on Wednesday. He's not going to play tonight. Richard Sherman, maybe he might play tonight. Kerry Williams, the former Eagles reject who has been getting nothing but torched the past 2 years in the Eagles secondary, he's the most experienced guy that might be back there for the Seahawks and their back four here. As for the Chiefs, they won 34-19 at Arizona. It was not a crisp offensive performance, especially for Alex Smith, who looked better, I read, in training camp this week as it closed on Wednesday. The first team offense, though, only a one field goal on 3 offensive drives. It was second unit with Chase Daniels at the helm that produced 3 touchdown drives. Now, Andy Reid says his starters are going to play about a half tonight. You know, here's the bottom line. Kansas City got a great pass rush on Arizona's quarterbacks last week. In fact, 13 times they hurried them, and I think that definitely helps the Chiefs when you consider what I told you about the shambles that Seattle's offensive line is in, okay? The distribution by the Kansas City quarterbacks, Smith and Chase Daniel, 10 different wide receivers caught balls, 143 rushing yards by the Chiefs, and you knew they had a good ground game, right, on 32 drives. But Chiefs' offensive line is a little battered here, too. And Seattle definitely can put the pressure on the quarterback, okay? Kansas City is going to be missing both its tackles, both starting tackles out here tonight. All that being said, your money tonight is going to come down to probably Chase Daniel, who's coming off a very good game, a journeyman who fits a role with Kansas City, or R.J. Archer with the Seattle Seahawks team on the road. I'd rather lay the 3 points with Kansas City at home, even though I know, trust me, I know being a lifelong Philadelphia Eagles fan, how Andy Reid is just a pathetic play in the preseason. All that being said, I would buy down the half point and still take Kansas City in this particular contest. Now, in terms of the Falcons-Jets games, listen, I don't have a particular opinion on this particular game, but I did handicap it, so let me pass on some of my preseason notes here for it. You know, Atlanta won last week 31-24 at home against the Titans in Marcus Mariota's pro debut. It was also Dan Quinn, their head coach's debut as well. Meanwhile, the Jets, just a couple days removed from that Geno Smith fiasco, lost 23-3 at Detroit. Ryan Fitzpatrick, the new starting quarterback, and the starters only played one series in that game. The defense only played two series. Tonight, Todd Bowles says that most of his starting lineup, both sides of the line of scrimmage, are going to play most likely the first half of this game. Their top two running back candidates, Tevin Coleman and Devonta Freeman, both dealing with injuries for Atlanta. I said that sentence wrong, but you get the drift. It's Atlanta's top two running backs. Matt Ryan, of course, is in there with the starters here tonight. He had a very nice debut, 6 for 6, 86 yards, one touchdown again for the Jets. You're going to see more Ryan Fitzpatrick and then Bryce Petty, the former Baylor star. I just really don't have an opinion on that one, but hey, I handicapped the game and I figured I'd pass on the game notes to you. Now, in baseball tonight, I'm going to go with the Toronto Blue Jays on the run line as a $1.10 dog at Anaheim against the Angels with David Price on the hill against Hector Santiago. Price was not particularly sharp in Friday's home loss to the Yankees as he got a no decision despite being tagged for 11 hits and 3 runs in 7 and a third innings. But listen, he still has a 1.61 earned run average in 3 starts since the Jays acquired him from the Tigers. And he's 7-2 with a 1.93 earned run average on the road this year, which is kind of a crazy little stat because you consider that he split his time between two teams, okay? However, it's also kind of interesting to note that he's lost his last 3 starts in Anaheim, and the Angels have hit him hard in those 3 starts with an ERA for Price of 5.48 in them. Hector Santiago, we just saw him on the Sunday night game against Kansas City, pitched his heart out again and had nothing to show for it. He's gotten 2 runs of support or less in 9 of his 13 starts in the Big A this season. And that's why his record's nothing to speak about, despite an excellent 2.61 earned run average. Pitched well at Kansas City on Sunday night, only gave up 2 runs and 3 hits in 7 innings. Jays opened up this road trip with a split of 2 games in Philadelphia. You know, they've only gone 2-3 in their last 5 games after winning 11 in a row and 14 out of 15. The offense has certainly quieted down, but kind of pales in comparison to what the Angels have done here as they've just, you know, they have played so poorly over the past 6 weeks. Remember going into the All-Star break, they were the team everybody was talking about. Albert Pujols and Mike Trout were just powering that lineup. Well, it, you know, the lights have gone out in that lineup. That's the problem. They lost 8-2 at home yesterday to the White Sox. They won the first 3 games in the series, but understand in that 4-game series, they only scored 10 runs. They had lost 17 out of 23 before beating the White Sox 3 out of 4 here to start this homestand. Again, Blue Jays up 3 games in the race for the top wild card spot against the Angels, but they're a sub-500 team on the road, 6 games under 500. All that being said, I'm looking at the pitching matchup. I'm looking at the team that has more offensive potential and has certainly delivered more offensively this season, although not on the road as much as they have at home. And I got to go with the Blue Jays, and I can't play David Price minus $1.65. So instead, I'll take the money back at plus $1.10 and lay the 1.5 runs with Price and the Jays on the road to go along with the Kansas City Chiefs. And again, guys, that line is 3. You know my philosophy. If the line is anywhere between 3 to 4.5 points, I'm buying the half point up or down accordingly. I just think that's a wise financial investment strategy. That'll do it, guys, for your Friday video report. Best of luck to you all, and I'll catch you again tomorrow when we do this one more time.